Hello students, in today's lecture I am going to discuss about a very interesting topic, that is Markovnikov rule and anti-Markovnikov rules. Basically these two rules are applicable for the addition of an unsymmetrical reagent to an unsymmetrical alkene. So we will discuss Markovnikov rule and anti-Markovnikov rule one by one. So first we will see what is Markovnikov's rule. Markovnikov was a scientist who stated that when an unsymmetrical reagent like HCl, HBr, HI adds to an unsymmetrical alkene, the positive part of the reagent will attach to that carbon of the carbon-carbon double bond which bears the greatest number of hydrogen atom. Now let's see the example. This is an unsymmetrical alkene. Why it is an unsymmetrical alkene? Because the carbon bearing carbon-carbon double bond have CH3 group at one side and no other group at this side. So this is an unsymmetrical alkene. When this unsymmetrical alkene was reacted with an unsymmetrical reagent like example HBr, so the positive part, like the hydrogen will bear the positive charge and bromine will bear the negative charge. So positive part of the reagent will attach to that carbon which bears the more number of hydrogen atom. So positive part will attack on this carbon. So the product will be now let's discuss the mechanism for this rule. In the first step, the unsymmetrical reagent, that is HBr, will break down into H positive and Br negative. So it is called the electrophile and it is called the nucleophile. Basically it is an electrophilic addition reaction and no other reagent is required to carry out this reaction. Now the next step is attack of electrophile on the carbon-carbon double bond. Now here are the two possibilities. This carbon-carbon double bond can be break in this direction or can be in this direction. Now I will written here A and here B. Now let's see these two possibilities. If I break the bond in this direction, in the direction of A, then what will happen? The electron will be shifted towards this carbon. So this carbon, second carbon, will bear the positive charge. Here the positive charge will come. And when this carbon will bear the negative charge, then the electrophile will attack on this carbon. That is the proton, H positive, will attack on this carbon. So the carbonium ion will form, or can say carbocation. And if we see the degree of this carbocation, it is secondary, or can say 2 degree carbocation, because the positive charge bearing carbon atom is further attached to the 2 carbon atoms. So it is 2 degree in nature. Now let's see the another possibility. If the bond is broken in this direction, then what will happen? The electron will be shifted towards this carbon and the positive charge will appear on the first carbon and the proton will attack in that case on the second carbon. Now the positive charge will appear on this carbon. It is also called the carbonium ion. And if we see the degree of this carbocation, it is 1 degree, because in this case the carbon bearing positive charge is attached to the one carbon only. So it is 1 degree. And we already know about this, the stability of carbon carbocation is 3 degrees more stable than 2 degree and 2 degrees more stable than 1 degree. This is the stability order of carbocation. So here are the two possibilities in the second step. One is 2 degree carbocation will form and one is 1 degree carbocation is formed. So we have seen that 2 degree carbocation is more stable. So this is the intermediate which is formed in the second step, and this intermediate will not be formed because it is least stable. So in the third step, this Br negative will attack on this intermediate carbocation. So this is the product formed as per the Markovnikov's rule. So the modern definition of Markovnikov rule states that The electrophilic addition to an unsymmetrical alkene is favored in that direction in which the more stable carbocation is formed. So it is all about the Markovnikov's rule. Now let's see anti-Markovnikov's rule. Next is anti-Markovnikov's rule. As the name itself indicates, anti-Markovnikov rule is just opposite to the Markovnikov rule. So this rule is also known as Kharash effect, as this rule is discovered by the scientist, which is known as Kharash. This rule is also known as peroxide effect, as the rule is applicable only when the reaction is carried out in the presence of peroxide. Now let's see the example. This is an unsymmetrical alkene, and to this unsymmetrical alkene, when an unsymmetrical reagent is added, basically in the presence of peroxide, like example. So this rule states that when an unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene in the presence of peroxide, the positive part of the reagent will attach to that carbon-carbon double bond which bears the less number of hydrogen atom. So it is a carbon-carbon bearing carbon-carbon double bond, and we can see one carbon it attached to one hydrogen only, and one carbon is attached to two hydrogen. So positive part will attach to that carbon which bears the less number of the hydrogen atom. So the product formed is 1-bromopropane. Now let's see the mechanism for this rule. Most importantly, it is a free radical addition reaction, as Markovnikov rule is electrophilic addition reaction, while the mechanism for the anti-Markovnikov rule is free radical mediated. So in the first step, the peroxide will be dissociated into the free radicals. This oxygen-oxygen double bond, because both side electronegativity difference is zero, so both will take one electron and dissociate it into the free radical. Alkoxide, free radical. This R indicate alkyl group. Now, as we know, the free radicals are very reactive species. This alkoxy free radical will attack on the HBr and to generate the bromine free radical. Now, this bromine free radical is very reactive, so this bromine free radical will attack on the unsymmetrical alkene. Now here again two possibilities arises. This bromine free radical can attack on this carbon or this carbon, depends whether the bond will broken in this direction or in this direction. Now here I am writing A, here I am writing B. So the two possibilities are, if the bond is broken in the direction of A, then the electron will be shifted towards this carbon. So the bromine free radical will attack on this carbon in that case. So the intermediate will form. Here the free radical charge will appear on this carbon and CH2Br. So here again a free radical is formed, which is as an intermediate. And if we see the degree of this intermediate, it is 2 degree, because the free radical bearing carbon atom is further attached to the 2 carbon atom. So it is 2 degree free radical. Now let's see the second probability. If bond is broken in this direction, then the bromine free radical will attack on this carbon. Then the free radical charge will appear on this carbon. And the degree of this free radical is 1 degree, because the free radical bearing carbon atom is attached to the one carbon only, and we know the stability. The 3 degree free radical is more stable than 2 degree, and 2 degree is more stable than 1 degree. So here in the second step, two possibilities are there. One is 2 degree free radical can form, or 1 degree free radical can form. And we know 2 degree free radical is more stable than 1 degree. So this is the possible intermediate which is formed in the second step, and this is not formed. So in the next step, this free radical, which is also very reactive, will attack on the HBr. To give the product, and bromine free radical will arise in this step. So this is the product formed as per the anti-Markovnikov's rule, that is 1-bromopropane. एंड ब्रोमीन फ्री रेडिकल विल अराइज इन दिस स्टेप एंड विच विल गो टू द थर्ड स्टेप एंड द रिएक्शन प्रोसीड अंटिल ऑल द फ्री रेडिकल्स आर कंज्यूम्ड इन द रिएक्शन एंड इट इज ऑल अबाउट द एंटी मार्कोनिकोफ रूल. Some important points are to be noted in the case of anti-Markovnikov's rule, that is the addition of HCl and HI. As HCl bond is stronger than HBr, so it is difficult to cleave this HCl bond symmetrically. So the reaction is difficult to carry out in the presence of HCl. Second, the HI bond is weaker than HBr bond, but when it is cleaved, the iodine free radical generated, which is coupled with another iodine free radical to generate the iodine molecule. So the iodine free radical does not react with this unsymmetrical alkene or the carbon-carbon double bond. So reaction does not happen. So these are the exception in the case of anti-Markovnikov's rule. So it is all about the Markovnikov's rule and anti-Markovnikov's rule. I hope you understand the lecture very well. Thank you so much.